Hello everyone, my name is Sonam Sandhu and today I'm here with a new session. I won't say a session, basically a series. I'm going to start this series and this will definitely help you in idea generation. I've been receiving various comments from the students. Basically, they are facing problem in idea generation. They are unable to generate ideas when it comes to a particular essay topic. So I'm going to take various topics and I'll teach you one of the topics in one session of mine. So today we have taken this essay and it's definitely task 2, an IELTS essay task 2 of IELTS writing module. And what exactly needs to be done here, I'll explain you the whole question in detail. I'll explain you how do you need to plan your answer, and afterwards I'll recommend you to write it on your own. So now you need not to find any teacher, you need not to look for any help. I'll be teaching you this writing essay, basically this essay writing myself, and then you are going to just frame your ideas, integrate your ideas in order to write a powerful essay. That's what we are going to do today, as the essay is also related to powerful thing. I'm going to teach you some powerful technique today. Let's get started, guys. Spoken communication is always more powerful than written communication. So basically, one of the major keywords here is communication. Okay, so they are mainly talking about communication here, and the word says spoken communication. So communication, theek hai, is always more powerful than written communication. So we have this statement. Every single time you are going to get one essay, so every essay is going to have one statement followed by a question. So guys, this is the statement and it is followed by a question. To what extent do you agree or disagree? We always need to analyze this statement properly, and then only we should start writing our answer. So what exactly do we need to do here? We'll understand the same and we are going to translate the same in our native language, in our local language, and in our regional language. That's exactly we'll be doing. So spoken, here they are talking about verbal skills. According to them, verbal skills or oral skills, okay, verbal skills, we can call these skills oral skills. Theek hai, spoken language, theek hai. So that's what they are saying, always more powerful, theek hai, always more powerful than written communication, than writing, than any form of writing, any piece of writing. ठीक है, then the written skills. So these are the synonyms. These synonyms can be easily used for this question type. So now you have understand this. Now you have understood the synonyms. And after this, what exactly needs to be done? ठीक है, you have understood the synonyms and now you are going to proceed further with the planning of the question. You have understood the question. The question is saying कि speaking skills, basically the verbal skills are always more powerful than written communication. Okay, so always influence more, we can say this, always more influential, we can say more influential okay, that's what we can say here, more influential than written communication. That's what they are saying, so we can write it easily. ठीक है, सो स्पोकन कम्युनिकेशन इज ऑलवेज मोर पावरफुल देन रिटन कम्युनिकेशन. टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट डू यू एग्री और डिसएग्री? सो गाइस, नाउ वी हैव अंडरस्टूड इट, ओके, कि द क्वेश्चन इज स्टेटिंग कि स्पीकिंग, ठीक है, ओरल स्किल्स आर मोर पावरफुल, मोर इन्फ्लुएंशियल देन रिटन स्किल्स. दैट्स व्हाट द क्वेश्चन इज सेइंग. एंड देन दे आर आस्किंग टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट डू यू एग्री और डिसएग्री. ठीक है, सो नाउ we have got the question, we have understood the question. What exactly do we need to do? We need to decide our opinion first. Now the next step is deciding the opinion. So you exactly need to decide what, decide the opinion. Okay, and the question is stating, to what extent do you agree or disagree? Okay, so you can say, I support. Spoken communication is always more powerful than written communication. What do you want to say? They are saying, to what extent do you agree? If they would have asked you, do you agree or disagree, it would have been clear. Simple logic, okay? Either agree or disagree. But now the question is saying, to what extent? That means if you are partially agreeing or partially disagreeing, that's what you need to tell here. So according to me, guys, my opinion is that both the communications, both the skills are indeed important. Okay, so to what extent do you agree or disagree? Then I'll be saying, this essay supports the above assertion. This essay feels or believes that both skills, okay, both the skills, spoken as well as written, are essential for an individual, or are essential for every individual, or are essential in everyday's life. So not only spoken skill but also the written communication is helpful in everyone's life. That's what I'm going to say. That means I'm not totally agreeing ki spoken English is more powerful. I'm saying ki I'm partially supporting the above opinion. And in my context, as far as my opinion is concerned, both the skills are important. Both the skills are essential. Now, what exactly do we need to do further? Spoken communication is always more powerful. According to me, both speaking and writing okay, ठीक है, और both verbal and written communication is essential. So that's what my point is. If I'm saying so, if I'm saying so, I actually need to support the same. In body paragraph 1, my question will be, why? ठीक है? Oral skills, ठीक है? Vital in, ठीक है? Life. Here you need not to bother about grammar. You are just going to frame your question. Why oral skills vital in life? Body paragraph 2. Why written skills important in life? So here you are going to mention this. You have to state your opinion directly in the introduction itself, and you are going to exactly mention what exactly you will be writing. So in body paragraph 1, why oral skills vital in life? Why written skills important in life? So first impression hota hai. Oral skills ka kya hai? It's the first impression. If you're meeting someone, he or she is going to judge you through your oral skills, through your verbal skills. So first impression, one judges you through your verbal skills. Okay. Up next is, we have to write, we can write one idea and we can explain it in detail. That's more than enough. Why written skills important in life? Mostly all the contracts. ठीक है? All the important orders, assignments will be signed, will be, okay, drafted instead of verbally, instead of verbal approval. So that's what is going to happen. Instead of verbal approval, all the contracts will be signed, will be drafted. So that's what they are saying. The written skills are also important because contracts, orders, assignments, all the important information, government orders will be drafted, okay, will be in written form only. They are not going to approve any order if you have just given your verbal approval. If I have stated that yes, I'm ready, I'll be taking your classes, and you have not made any, let's say I'm just saying I'm taking your classes, I'll be taking your classes, but maybe after 4 or 5 days I'll be like, no, I did not say so. So I just said it verbally, and written communication is basically the proof. So it acts as a proof when it comes to any new contract orders. It doesn't mean oral skills are not important. Oral skills are indeed important. Both the skills are essential, because first impression, one judges you through your verbal skills, okay? If you're meeting someone for the first time, he or she will be seeing the way you speak, not exactly the way you write. So these are definitely important in life, okay? You can, if you want to be famous, you have to speak well, okay? Yahan pe you can give example of any celebrity, okay? The one who didn't know English, but he or she had to learn English. You can take example of Kangana Ranaut as well. She did not know how to speak in English, but later on she learned it. So definitely oral skills are vital in life. So what exactly are we doing here, guys? We have a question here. We understood the question in detail. After understanding the question, we actually paraphrase the main words, rephrase the main words. After that, I have written my opinion. We need to decide our opinion. And after deciding the opinion, we are going step by step, okay? So firstly, we paraphrased. We look at this. We just looked at the statement. We paraphrased. After paraphrasing, we decided our opinion, okay? So after deciding the opinion, my opinion was both speaking and writing communication, okay, is essential. Then, why oral skills vital in life? So first impression, one judges you through your verbal skills. You're going to write this. If you'll write a question like such, just after in the body paragraph one, why oral skills vital in life? Why written skills important in life? If you're going to write a question like such, okay, then what is going to happen? You'll actually understand the question in detail and you'll know what exactly you have to write in a particular paragraph. You'll never get confused. So try to plan your answer like such. And guys, now talking about the third paragraph. Whenever we have any essay, advantages, to what extent do you agree or disagree? Do the advantages outweigh disadvantages? Then we are going to make three paragraphs. Here also we'll make the third paragraph, and in the third one we'll say how both skills have equal importance. So how, kaise equally important hai? That's what you're going to tell. Before getting the contract, you actually need to, ab aapko koi contract chahiye, before even getting the contract, you need to persuade a person through your communication skills, through your spoken skills, okay, and your confidence as well. So that's what you're going to write. You're going to actually say if they are equally important, how they are equally important. That's what you're going to mention here. So this is what we'll be doing in body paragraph 3. So guys, this is the way we are going to plan one answer. So please let me know whether you like the video, what kind of, if you have any question in the mind and you are confused that I'm unable to answer a particular question, I'm unable to get ideas for this particular question in essay writing, you just let me know in the comment section. I just look at each and every comment myself and I'll be answering it as well. And I'm going to make a video on the same. So that's what I'm going to do through this. So now you're going to see these videos, these premieres regularly, and it will help you in improving your idea generation part in essay writing. So I hope this will prove to be useful for you. Thanks a lot for watching this and hope to see you soon.